Thank you, Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen of the Senate. I know for some folks have said, why is this coming out now? And the reason is it took from January to this point to get a bill to where we believe meets all the necessary things we have for law enforcement, fire, EMS, training services, and the function of the funding. I should mention that I've been working with all the fire services, law enforcement services around the state this whole session on this particular bill. And it's taken this much time to get it done. Much like when we worked on the Economic Development Authority bill last year, it took 3.5, 4, or 5 months to get that bill up and running, and no one said that came out late. I would submit that that's the same thing with this public safety training bill. We actually got it out of state government before the funnel. It went to another committee, and since then we've been working on it. So I hope that not only my colleagues here support this, but also support on the House side to go ahead and move this bill down to the governor this year, because I believe it is a good bill for law enforcement and fire to come together, which has not happened probably in 100 years, on one thing. So they all have, everybody's got their pieces, but the islands are now together. And so I think that's an important piece of this. My amendment merely lays out what the task force, this is not a board, this is a task force, should look like. And the purpose behind it was to try to make it as equal as we could amongst fire services, law enforcement services, along with getting a public member on there, someone from the community colleges on there, and with the governor's appointees on there. So the Iowa Law Enforcement Academy director, Commissioner Noble, and others will be on this board. And if everybody has seen the amendment, there's quite a few things in there you all can read. But if you read through this, amongst fire, EMS, there are 10 members. And then there are 10 members from all the different law enforcement agencies. And then we have the public member, citizen appointed by the governor, and then community colleges. So we come out with about a 24-member board, or not a board, excuse me, a task force. Their job, and as Senator Danielson will explain probably further, but their job is to come up with what a board would look like, submit that to us so that it's equal representation, so that when we do get the trust fund up and running, everyone has a say about how the money will be spent for training and equipment for all these different areas. The vision of this thing is also to do a joint campus at some point. I learned late last night, and I spoke to the Iowa National Guard, Captain Barton, this morning, that they are also working on a joint facility through Camp Dodge. They're looking at about a $22 million project, federal dollars. They don't have the money yet, but they have in the plans to tear down some buildings, but also to fix up the Iowa Law Enforcement Academy. They are very excited about this bill because they believe that they can expand their earlier vision to make sure that we have a public safety academy campus that's all expansive, that does include EMS, fire, homeland security, the feds can come. This is what we've been trying to work for years since 9/11, and we have an opportunity in the state to do it now. So if you look at what we're trying to do here in the task force, it's merely to help set up what needs to happen down the road. They have to always come back to us for things. They have to come back with us on the board, a location of a campus, what the campus would look like, approximate costs. So I believe and I hope that we get full support from all the senators here. Mr. President, I would move the amendment if there are no questions.